neuromuscular scoliosis is any child that has scoliosis and also has a diagnosed sort of underlying neuromuscular condition. The most common reason I see children that have neuromuscular scoliosis would be they have cerebral palsy. But then I also see children that have spinal muscular atrophy, Charcot-Marie tooth, or some other peripheral neuropathy. But basically, in general, they have a diagnosed condition that makes their muscles or nerves function differently. So the muscle control over their spine and their trunk is different, and then they kind of slowly develop a scoliotic curve over time. So some of the children get it really early, even at the age of 1 or 2, and some of the children don't start to develop a scoliosis until like the teens or early adolescence. We have created a multi-interdisciplinary clinic here so that before surgery, your child can come in. It's a long appointment, but in one appointment, they can see the anesthesiologist, the pulmonologist, the developmental pediatrician who works a lot with like bowel regimen and kind of overall health. Then you can see the neurologist, you can see the occupational therapist, the physical therapist, the dentist, the nutritionist, the psychologist, the social worker, and child life. And we all work as a big group and try to do everything we can to optimize any other organ system problem you have so that when you do have surgery, hopefully number one, we can avoid an infection, but hopefully number two, we can avoid all the other complications. You don't have to stay in the hospital as long, and then when you go home, you have all the equipment and all the needs that you have to go home safely, taken care of in a really efficient manner. So some of the kids who have neuromuscular scoliosis, their curves have gotten just like terribly out of control. So it's not, sadly not unusual that I see a patient whose curve is like 120 to like 160 degrees. I mean, it is a very bad curve. And if I try to treat that with just a surgery, oftentimes I have to do what we call a front back, where you have to go in from the front and kind of release everything and then flip the patient over and then put all the instrumentation in from the back. So it's a much, you know, more involved surgery. It's sort of more stressful on the patient. So in order to try to avoid that really, really big surgery, we will employ a technique we call halogravity traction, where we put pins in the skull, and then those pins are attached to a ring. Then we can pull traction through that ring and slowly lengthen, and I call it like uncoil the spine through gradual, progressive traction. And so some of these neuromuscular kids will go into halogravity traction for anywhere between 4 to 8 weeks before surgery. And then a lot of the times we can avoid that anterior surgery and just do the posterior surgery. And it's a lot less hard on the patient, and the recovery is easier.